My spirit shall not always strive with man, for that he also is flesh. Yet his days shall be 120 years. There were giants in the earth in those days, and also after that, when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men, and they bare children to them, the same became mighty men, which were of old, men of renown. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing, and the fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
That the Illuminati have kept protected is evidence which incontrovertibly proves the existence of a technologically advanced pre-flood civilization. I'm talking about Atlantis. They were on par with our own technology, and this has been totally erased from our history. And why has this happened? Well, obviously, so they can insert this devil and in that way brainwash and control the human race, which they have done exceedingly well. But we have preserved this secret, and we have the evidence, and we will present the evidence which proves the existence of Atlantis.
stuff, aren't they? Well, they don't love you.
Yeah.
Right now.
Yeah.
This is where the idea of the divine right to rule comes from. The divine right to rule because of what? Because of your bloodline, because of your DNA. This goes right back to the ancient world.
Why do we need reptiles for that? Human beings are schmucky enough to want to rule over each other.
Listen, you can tell me anything you believe, and I can start taking it apart on the basis of a little chat in front of this place. Right,
but what I'm saying all the time is, summarize their works in television interviews,
and that's what I'm trying to tell you.
Okay.
If you look at the ancient world, all over the ancient world, you find the same recurring story of the interbreeding between humans and non-humans, which invariably are depicted in a reptilian form, creating hybrid bloodlines, the bloodline of the gods.
It all goes back to the proof that we are in fact connected by a field of energy. 1944, Max Planck, a Nobel Prize winning physicist, he made a statement. It was so profound. He said, what we see as matter doesn't really exist the way we think it exists. He said, behind everything we see as matter, he said, there is a conscious and intelligent mind that is the matrix. That was his word. The matrix of all matter.
Built to keep us under control in order to change a human being into this.
No. I don't believe it. It's not possible.
I didn't say it would be easy, Neo. I just said it would be the truth.
Stop! Let me out! Let me out!
There exists on Earth, already exists on Earth, a being which is in many ways similar to us. And all we have to do, and those are quotes from his words in his autobiography, all we have to do is put our mark on it, our genetic mark, and thereby raise that being more to our level so that it could follow our commands, understand our language, and do the work for us. And there are quite a number of texts called creation texts that describe.
Jondy's actions with spirits or conversations with angels that he carried out throughout his life, but particularly in the 1580s.
Change the human being into this. Kulanina rises up to, and then something watches this to take place. What is that that watches Kundalini?
Okay.
Is it the Atlanteans' Hall of Records Casey spoke of? No one has explored it further.
Thank you.
The constellations of the zodiac locate the Earth in the universe. The Pyramidion has a perimeter precisely 12 cubits long. The presence of pi points us to a circle. Together, that refers to a 12-zone circle, the zodiac. The four angles of the pyramid refer to the four signs of the zodiac: Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, and Aquarius. In the ancient world, Scorpio was represented by an eagle and Aquarius by an angel. These signs are carved in stone on the front of this cathedral. Four stars belong to these four signs. They used to be called the four guardians of heaven. They are Aldebaran in the Taurus constellation, Regulus in Leo, Antarius in Scorpio, and Formahart on top of Pisces today, but previously in Aquarius. These stars keep the same position and relation to each other. They can be used as steady points of reference through time. This is the Taurus-Scorpio axis, formerly known as the Taurus-Eagle axis, shown by the Babylonians as a winged bull. This is the Leo-Angel axis. Its symbol is in front of our noses, here on the Giza Plateau, the Sphinx, a man's head on a lion's body. These stars keep the same position and relation to each other. They can be used as steady points of reference through time.
After this, I looked, and behold, a door was opened in heaven. And the first voice which I heard was as it were of a trumpet talking with me, which said, Come up hither, and I will show thee things which must be hereafter. And immediately I was in the Spirit. And behold, a throne was set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. And he that sat was to look upon like a jasper and a sardine stone. And there was a rainbow round about the throne, in sight like unto an emerald. And round about the throne were 24 seats, and upon the seats I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white raiment, and they had on their heads crowns of gold. And out of the throne proceeded lightnings and thunderings and voices. And there were 7 lamps of fire burning before the throne, which are the 7 spirits of God. And before the throne there was a sea of glass like unto crystal. And in the midst of the throne, and round about the throne, were 4 beasts, full of eyes, before and behind. And the first beast was like a lion, and the second beast like a calf, and the third beast had a face as a man, and the fourth beast was like a flying eagle. And the 4 beasts had each of them 6 wings about him, and they were full of eyes within. And they rest not day and night, saying, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. And when those beasts give glory and honor and thanks to him that sat on the throne, who liveth forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him that sat on the throne, and worship him that liveth forever and ever, and cast their crowns before the throne, saying, Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are and were created.
Archaeologists believe the Sphinx was built long after the Great Pyramid, but they may be wrong. Look at this. This triangle is the same shape as the Great Pyramid. One side runs through the Sphinx's head. If we outline the base of the Great Pyramid and shift it sideways and extend the right side, it hits the Sphinx's head. And if we trace a circle like this, once again we hit the Sphinx's head in exactly the same spot. This could be the answer we're looking for. Giza is an astronomical clock whose dial was the four stars. In addition, the clock's hand, the Sphinx's gaze, turns around itself every 26,000 years and lets us point precisely to the Earth's position in this big cycle. But how do we know when the cycle begins? There is a mysterious bump on the Sphinx's chest that Arabs call the Lion's Heart. The Lion's Heart is also the Arabic name for the brightest star in the Leo constellation, Regulus. The Sphinx has always been a symbol for enigma. She speaks to mankind with the famous riddle, who starts his day on four legs, continues on two legs, and finishes on three legs? Remember the answer: man and his destiny. When the Sphinx's eyes line up with the star Regulus, the Lion's Heart, then a new cycle of the equinoxes begins. This huge clock, our planet's clock, makes a full circle every 26,000 years. Thank you.
Thank you.